Surah 5, Al-Ma'idah, The Table. In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the Most Compassionate. Believers, honor your bonds. All grazing beasts of the flock are permitted to you, except those which are recited to you hereinafter. But you are not allowed to hunt in the state of ihram, the state of pilgrim sanctity. Indeed, Allah decrees as He wills. Believers, neither desecrate the symbols of devotion to Allah, nor the holy month, nor the animals of offering, nor the animals wearing collars indicating they are for sacrifice, nor ill-treat those who have set out for the holy house, seeking from their Lord His bounty and good pleasure. But once you are free from pilgrimage obligations, you are free to hunt. Do not let your wrath against the people who have barred you from the holy mosque move you to commit undue transgressions. Rather, help one another in acts of righteousness and piety, and do not help one another in sin and transgression. Fear Allah. Surely, Allah is severe in retribution. Forbidden to you are carrion, blood, the flesh of swine, the animal slaughtered in any name other than Allah's, the animal which has either been strangled, killed by blows, has died of a fall, or by goring, or devoured by a beast of prey, unless it be that which you yourselves might have slaughtered while it was still alive, and forbidden to you also that which was slaughtered at the altars. You are also forbidden to seek knowledge of your fate by divining arrows. All these are sinful acts. This day, the unbelievers have fully despaired of your religion. Do not fear them, but fear me. This day, I have perfected for you your religion, and have bestowed upon you my bounty in full measure, and have been pleased to assign for you Islam as your religion. Follow then the lawful and unlawful bounds enjoined upon you. As for he who is driven by hunger, without being willfully inclined to sin, surely Allah is all-forgiving, all-compassionate. They ask you what has been made lawful to them. Say that all clean things have been made lawful to you. And such hunting animals as you teach, training them to hunt, teaching them the knowledge Allah has given you, you may eat what they catch for you, but invoke the name of Allah on it. Have fear of Allah in violating His law. Allah is swift in His reckoning. This day, all clean things have been made lawful to you. The food of the people of the book is permitted to you, and your food is permitted to them. And permitted to you are chaste women, be they from among the believers or from among those who have received the book before you, provided you become their protectors in wedlock after paying them their bridal due, rather than going around committing fornication and taking them as secret companions. The work of he who refuses to follow the way of faith will go to waste, and he will be among the utter losers in the hereafter. Believers, when you stand up for prayer, wash your faces and your hands up to the elbows, and wipe your heads and wash your feet up to the ankles. And if you are in the state of ritual impurity, purify yourselves by taking a bath. But if you are either ill or traveling or have satisfied a want of nature or have had intimate contact with women and find no water, then have recourse to clean earth. And wipe your faces and your hands therewith. Allah does not want to lay any hardship upon you. Rather, He wants to purify you and complete His favors upon you so that you may give thanks. Remember Allah's favor upon you and His covenant which He made with you when you said, "We have heard and we obey." So do fear Allah. Allah has full knowledge even of that which is hidden in the breasts of people. Believers, be upright bearers of witness for Allah, and do not let the enmity of any people move you to deviate from justice. Act justly, that is nearer to God-fearing, and fear Allah. Surely, Allah is well aware of what you do. Allah has promised those who believe and do righteous deeds forgiveness from sins and a great reward. As for those who disbelieve and give the lie to our signs, they are destined for the blazing flame. Believers, remember Allah's favor upon you. When a certain people decided to stretch their hands against you, He restrained their hands from you. Do fear Allah. Men of faith should put their trust only in Allah. Surely, Allah took a covenant with the children of Israel. And we raised up from them 12 of their leaders. And Allah said, "Behold, I am with you. If you establish prayer and pay zakah and believe in my prophets and help them and lend Allah a goodly loan, I will certainly efface from you your evil deeds. And will surely cause you to enter the gardens beneath which rivers flow. Whosoever of you disbelieves thereafter has indeed gone astray from the right way." Then for their breach of covenant, we cast them away from our mercy and cause their hearts to harden. And now they are in such a state that they pervert words from their context and distort their meaning and have forgotten a good portion of the teaching they were imparted. And regarding all except a few of them, you continue to learn that they committed acts of treachery. Pardon them then, and overlook their deeds. Surely, Allah loves those who act benevolently. We also took a covenant from those who said, We are Christians, Nasara, but they forgot a good portion of the teaching they had been imparted. Wherefore, we aroused enmity and spite between them till the day of resurrection, and ultimately, Allah will tell them what they used to do. People of the book, now our messenger has come to you. He makes clear to you a good many things of the book which you were wont to conceal, and also passes over many things. There has now come to you a light from Allah and a clear book, through which Allah shows to all who seek to please Him the paths leading to safety. He brings them out by His leave, from darkness to light, and directs them on the straight way. Indeed, those who said, Christ the Son of Mary, He indeed is God, were guilty of unbelief. Say, O Muhammad, who could have overruled Allah had He so willed to destroy Christ, the Son of Mary, and His mother, and all those who are on earth? For to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth and all that is between them. He creates what He wills. Allah is all-powerful. The Jews and the Christians say, We are Allah's children and His beloved ones. Ask them, Why then does He chastise you for your sins? You are the same as other human beings He has created. He forgives whom He wills and chastises whom He wills. And to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth and all that is between them. To Him is the eventual return. People of the book, after a long interlude during which no messengers appeared, there has come to you our messenger to elucidate the teaching of the true faith, lest you say, No bearer of glad tidings and no warner has come to us. For now there indeed has come to you a bearer of glad tidings and a warner. Allah is all-powerful. Remember when Moses said to his people, My people, recall Allah's favor upon you when He raised prophets among you and appointed you rulers and granted to you what He had not granted to anyone else in the world. My people, enter the Holy Land which Allah has ordained for you and do not turn back, for then you will turn about losers. They answered, Moses, therein live a ferocious people. We will not enter unless they depart from it. But if they do depart from it, then we will surely enter it. Two from among these men who were frightened but upon whom Allah had bestowed His favor said, Enter upon them through the gate, for if you do enter, you will be the victors, and put your trust in Allah if indeed you are people of faith. Nevertheless, they said, O Moses, never shall we enter it as long as they are there. Go forth then, you and your Lord, and fight both of you. As for us, we will remain sitting here. Thereupon Moses said, My Lord, I have control over none but my own self and my brother, so make a distinction between us and the transgressing people. Allah said, This land will now be forbidden to them for 40 years, and they will remain wandering about on earth. Do not grieve over the condition of these transgressing people. Narrate to them in all truth the story of the two sons of Adam, when both of them made an offering, and it was accepted from one of them and was not accepted from the other. The latter said, I will surely kill you. Thereupon the former said, Allah only accepts offerings from the God-fearing. Even if you stretch forth your hand against me to kill me, I will not stretch forth my hand to kill you. Surely I fear Allah, the Lord of the entire universe. I would desire that you be laden with my sin and with your own sin, and thus become among the inmates of the fire. That indeed is the right recompense of the wrongdoers. At last his evil soul drove him to the murder of his brother, and he killed him, whereby he himself became one of the losers. Thereupon Allah sent forth a raven, who began to scratch the earth, to show him how he might cover the corpse of his brother. So seeing, he cried, Woe unto me! Was I unable even to be like this raven, and find a way to cover the corpse of my brother? Then he became full of remorse at his doing. Therefore, we ordain for the children of Israel that he who slays a soul, unless it be in punishment for murder or for spreading mischief on earth, shall be as if he had slain all mankind. And he who saves a life shall be as if he had given life to all mankind. And indeed, again and again did our messengers come to them with clear directives, yet many of them continued to commit excesses on earth. Those who wage war against Allah and His Messenger and go about the earth spreading mischief, indeed their recompense is that they either be done to death or be crucified, or have their hands and feet be cut off from the opposite sides, or they be banished from the land. Such shall be their degradation in this world, and a mighty chastisement lies in store for them in the world to come. Except for those who repent before you have overpowered them, know well that Allah is all-forgiving, all-compassionate. Believers, fear Allah and seek the means to come near to Him, and strive hard in His way. Maybe you will attain true success. For those who disbelieved, even if they had all that is in the earth and the like of it with it, and they had offered it all as ransom from chastisement on the day of resurrection, it will not be accepted of them. A painful chastisement lies in store for them. They will wish to come out of the fire, but they will not. Theirs will be a long-lasting chastisement. As for the thief, male or female, cut off the hands of both. This is a recompense for what they have done, and an exemplary punishment from Allah. Allah is Almighty, All-Wise. But he who repents after he has committed wrong and makes amends, Allah will graciously turn to him. Truly, Allah is all-forgiving, all-compassionate. Do you not know that to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth? He chastises whom He wills and forgives whom He wills. Allah is all-powerful. O Messenger, do not be grieved on account of those who vie with one another in disbelieving, even though they be those who say with their mouths, "We believe," but their hearts have no faith, or they be Jews who have their ears eagerly turned to falsehood and spy for other people who did not chance to come to you, who pervert the words of Allah, taking them out of their proper context in order to distort their meaning. They say to people, "If such and such teaching is given to you, accept it. If you are not given that, then avoid it." You can be of no avail to him whom Allah wills to fall into error. Those are the ones whose hearts Allah does not want to purify. For them, there is degradation in this world and a mighty chastisement in the next. They are listeners of falsehood and greedy devourers of unlawful earnings. If they come to you for your judgment, you may either judge between them or turn away from them. And were you to turn away from them, they shall not be able to harm you. And were you to judge between them, judge with justice. Surely, Allah loves the just. Yet how will they appoint you a judge when they have the Torah with them, wherein there is Allah's judgment, and still they turn away from it? The fact is, they are not believers. Surely, we revealed the Torah, wherein there is guidance and light. Thereby did prophets, who had submitted themselves to Allah, judge for the Judaized folk, and so did the scholars and jurists. They judged by the book of Allah, for they had been entrusted to keep it and bear witness to it. So, O Jews, do not fear human beings, but fear me, and do not barter away my signs for a trivial gain. Those who do not judge by what Allah has revealed are indeed the unbelievers. And therein we had ordained for them a life for a life, and an eye for an eye, and a nose for a nose, and an ear for an ear, and a tooth for a tooth, and for all wounds, like for like. But whosoever forgoes it by way of charity, it will be for him an expiation. Those who do not judge by what Allah has revealed are indeed the wrongdoers. And we sent Jesus, the son of Mary, after those prophets, confirming the truth of whatever there still remained of the Torah. And we gave him the gospel, wherein is guidance and light, and which confirms the truth of whatever there still remained of the Torah, and a guidance and admonition for the God-fearing. Let the followers of the gospel judge by what Allah has revealed therein. And those who do not judge by what Allah has revealed are the transgressors. Then we revealed the book to you, O Muhammad, with truth, confirming whatever of the book was revealed before and protecting and guarding over it. Judge, then, in the affairs of men in accordance with the law that Allah has revealed, and do not follow their desires in disregard of the truth which has come to you. For each of you, we have appointed a law and a way of life. And had Allah so willed, He would surely have made you one single community. Instead, He gave each of you a law and a way of life, in order to test you by what He gave you. Vie then with one another in good works. Unto Allah is the return of all of you, and He will then make you understand the truth concerning the matters on which you disagreed. Therefore, judge between them, O Muhammad, by what Allah has revealed, and do not follow their desires, and beware lest they tempt you away from anything of what Allah has revealed to you. And if they turn away, then know well that Allah has indeed decided to afflict them for some of their sins. For surely, many of them are transgressors. If they turn away from the law of Allah, do they desire judgment according to the law of ignorance? But whose judgment can be better than Allah's for those who have certainty of belief? Believers, do not take Jews and Christians for your allies. They are the allies of each other, and among you, he who takes them for allies shall be regarded as one of them. Allah does not guide the wrongdoers. Indeed, you see that those afflicted with the disease of hypocrisy race towards them, saying, "We fear lest some misfortune overtakes us." And it may happen that Allah will either bring you a decisive victory or bring about something else from Himself, and then they will feel remorseful at their hypocrisy, which they have kept concealed in their breasts. While those who believe will exclaim, "Are these the self-same people who solemnly swore by Allah that they were with you? All their acts have gone to waste, and now they are the losers." Believers, if any of you should ever turn away from your faith, remember that Allah will raise up a people whom He loves and who love Him, a people humble towards the believers and firm towards the unbelievers, who will strive hard in the way of Allah and will not fear the reproach of the reproacher. This is the favor of Allah which He grants to whom He wills. Allah is all resourceful, all knowing. Only Allah, His Messenger, and those who believe and who establish prayer, pay zakah, and bow down before Allah are your allies. All those who accept Allah and His Messenger and the believers as their allies should remember that the party of Allah will be triumphant. Believers, do not take for your allies those who make a mockery and sport of your faith, be they those given the book before you or other unbelievers. Fear Allah if you indeed believe. And when you are called to pray, they take it for a mockery and sport, that because there are people who do not understand. Say to them, "People of the book, do you hate us for anything else except that we believe in Allah and in the teaching which has been revealed to us and in the teaching which was revealed before? Indeed, most of you are transgressors." Then say to them, "Shall I tell you about those whose retribution with Allah will be even worse? They are the ones whom Allah has cursed and have incurred His wrath, and some of whom were changed into apes and swine, and who serve the false deities. Such have an even worse rank and have strayed farther away from the right path." Whenever they come to you, they say, "We believe," whereas in fact they come disbelieving and go away disbelieving, and Allah knows all that they hide. You will see many of them hastening towards sin and transgression and devouring unlawful earnings. Evil indeed is what they do. Why is it that their scholars and jurists do not forbid them from sinful utterances and devouring unlawful earnings? Indeed, they have been contriving evil. The Jews say, "The hand of Allah is fettered." It is their own hands which are fettered, and they stand cursed for the evil they have uttered. No, His hands are outspread. He spends as He wills. Surely the message that has been revealed to you from your Lord has increased many of them in their insurgence and unbelief. And so, we have cast enmity and spite among them until the day of resurrection. And as often as they kindle the fire of war, Allah extinguishes it, and they go about trying to spread mischief on earth, whereas Allah does not love those who spread mischief. Had the people of the book only believed and been God-fearing, we should surely have effaced from them their evil deeds and caused them to enter the gardens of bliss. Had the people of the book observed the Torah and the Gospel and all that had been revealed to them from their Lord, sustenance would have been showered over them from above and would have risen from beneath their feet. Some among them certainly keep to the right path, but many of them do things that are evil. O Messenger, deliver what has been revealed to you from your Lord, for if you fail to do that, you have not fulfilled the task of His messengership. Allah will certainly protect you from the evil of men. Surely, Allah will not guide the unbelievers to succeed against you. Say to them, "People of the book, you have no solid ground to stand on unless you establish the Torah and the Gospel and all that had been revealed to you from your Lord. Indeed, the message revealed to you from your Lord will lead to the aggravation of insurgence and unbelief in many of them. So do not grieve for those who disbelieve. Know well, none has an exclusive claim to the truth. For all those who believe in Allah and in the last day and do good deeds, whether they are Muslims or Jews or Sabians or Christians, neither fear shall fall upon them, nor shall they have any reason to grieve. We took a covenant from the children of Israel and sent to them many messengers. But whenever any messenger brought to them something that did not suit their desires, they gave the lie to some of them and killed the others, thinking that no harm would come from it. Thus they became blind and deaf to the truth. Thereafter Allah turned towards them in gracious forgiveness, but many of them became even more deaf and blind to the truth. Allah sees all that they do. And surely they disbelieved when they said, Christ, the son of Mary, is indeed God. Whereas Christ had said, Children of Israel, serve Allah, who is your Lord and my Lord. Allah has forbidden paradise to those who associate anything with Him in His divinity, and their refuge shall be the fire. No one will be able to help such wrongdoers. Those who said, Allah is one of the three, certainly they disbelieved, for there is no God save the one God. And if they do not give up this claim, all who have disbelieved among them shall be subjected to a painful chastisement. Will they not then turn to Allah in repentance and ask for His forgiveness? Allah is all-forgiving, all-compassionate. The Messiah, son of Mary, was no more than a messenger, before whom many messengers have passed away, and his mother adhered wholly to truthfulness, and they both ate food as other mortals do. See how we make our signs clear to them, and see where they are turning away? Say, do you serve instead of Allah that which has no power either to harm or benefit, whereas Allah alone is all-hearing, all-knowing? Say, people of the book, do not exceed the proper limits in your religion at the cost of truth, and do not follow the caprices of the people who strayed before and caused others to go astray and strayed far away from the right path. Those of the children of Israel who took to unbelief have been cursed by the tongue of David and Jesus, the son of Mary, for they rebelled and exceeded the bounds of right. They did not forbid each other from committing the abominable deeds they committed. Evil indeed was what they did. And now you can see many of them taking the unbelievers instead of the believers for their allies. Indeed, they have sent forth evil for themselves. Allah is angry with them, and they shall abide in chastisement. For had they truly believed in Allah and the Messenger and what was sent down to him, they would not have taken the unbelievers instead of believers for their allies. But many of them have altogether rebelled against Allah. Of all people, you will find the Jews and those who associate others with Allah in His divinity to be the most hostile to those who believe, and you will surely find that of all people, they who say, we are Christians, are closest to feeling affection for those who believe. This because there are worshipful priests and monks among them, and because they are not arrogant. And when they hear what has been revealed to the messenger, you see that their eyes overflow with tears because of the truth that they recognize. And they say, Our Lord, we do believe. Write us down, therefore, with those who bear witness to the truth. And why should we not believe in Allah and the truth which has come down to us when we do fervently desire that our Lord should include us among the righteous? So Allah rewarded them for these words with the gardens beneath which rivers flow, so that they would abide there forever. Such is the reward of the people who do good. Those who disbelieved and gave the lie to our signs are rightfully the inmates of the blazing flame. Believers, do not hold as unlawful the good things which Allah has made lawful to you, and do not exceed the bounds of right. Allah does not love those who transgress the bounds of right. And partake of the lawful, good things which Allah has provided you as sustenance, and refrain from disobeying Allah in whom you believe. Allah does not take you to task for the oaths you utter vainly, but He will certainly take you to task for the oaths you have sworn in earnest. The expiation for breaking such oaths is either to feed 10 needy persons with more or less the same food as you are wont to give to your families, or to clothe them, or to set free from bondage the neck of one man, and he who does not find the means shall fast for 3 days. This shall be the expiation for your oaths whenever you have sworn and broken them, and do keep your oaths. Thus does Allah make clear to you His commandments. Maybe you will be grateful. Believers, intoxicants, games of chance, idolatrous sacrifices at altars, and divining arrows are all abominations, the handiwork of Satan. So turn wholly away from it, that you may attain to true success. By intoxicants and games of chance, Satan only desires to create enmity and hatred among you, and to turn you away from the remembrance of Allah and from prayer. Will you then desist? Obey Allah and obey the Messenger and beware. But if you turn away, then know well that our Messenger had merely to deliver the message clearly. There will be no blame on those who believe and do righteous deeds for whatever they might have partaken in the past, as long as they refrain from the things prohibited and persist in their faith and do righteous deeds, and continue to refrain from whatever is forbidden and submit to divine commandments, and persevere in doing good, fearing Allah. Allah loves those who do good. Believers, Allah will surely try you with a game which will be within the range of your hands, and lances so that He might mark out those of you who fear Him, even though He is beyond the reach of perception. A painful chastisement awaits whosoever transgresses the bounds set by Allah after His firm warning. Believers, do not kill game while you are in the state of pilgrim sanctity. Whoever of you kills it willfully, there shall be a recompense, the like of what he has killed in cattle, as shall be judged by two persons of equity among you, to be brought to the Kaaba as an offering, or feed the needy as an expiation, or its equivalent in fasting in order that he may taste the grievousness of his deed. Allah has pardoned whatever has passed, but Allah will exact a penalty from him who repeats it. Allah is Almighty, He is fully capable of exacting retribution. The game of the water and eating thereof are permitted to you as a provision for those of you who are settled and for those on a journey, but to hunt on land while you are in the state of pilgrim sanctity is forbidden for you. Beware then of disobeying Allah, to whom all of you shall be mustered. Allah has appointed the Kaaba, the sacred house, as a means of support for the collective life of people, and has caused the holy month, a pilgrimage, and the animals of sacrificial offering and their distinguishing colors to assist therein. This is so that you may know that Allah is aware of all that is in the heavens and all that is in the earth, and that Allah has knowledge of everything. Know well that Allah is severe in retribution, and that Allah is also all-forgiving, all-compassionate. The messenger is bound only to deliver the message, whereafter Allah knows well all that you disclose and all that you conceal.
قُلْ لَا يَسْتَوِي الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ
O Messenger, say to them, the bad things and the good things are not equal, even though the abundance of the bad things might make you pleased with them. People of understanding, beware of disobeying Allah. Maybe you will attain true success. Believers, do not ask of the things which, if made manifest to you, would vex you, for if you should ask about them while the Quran is being revealed, they will be made manifest to you. Allah has pardoned whatever happened in the past. He's all-forgiving, all-forbearing. Indeed, some people before you had asked such questions, and in consequence fell into unbelief. Allah has neither appointed cattle consecrated to idols such as Bahira, Saiba, Vasila, or Ham. But those who disbelieve forge lies against Allah, and of them most have no understanding, and therefore succumb to such superstitions. When they are asked, come to what Allah has revealed, and come to the messenger, they reply, the way of our forefathers suffices us. Will they continue to follow their forefathers, even though their forefathers might have known nothing and might have been on the wrong way? Believers, take heed as regards your own selves. If you are rightly guided, the error of he who strays will not harm you. To Allah will all of you return, then He will let all of you know what you did. Believers, when death approaches you, let two persons of equity among you act as witness when you make your bequest, or let two of those from others than yourselves act as witnesses if you are on a journey when the affliction of death befalls you. Then if any doubt occurs, you shall detain both of them in the mosque after the prayer, and they shall swear by Allah. We shall neither sell our testimony in return for any gain, even though it concerns any near of kin, nor shall we conceal our testimony which we owe to Allah, for then we should become among the sinners. Then, if it is discovered later that the two are guilty of such sin, then two others shall stand in their place from among those against whom the two had sinfully deposed, and swear by Allah. Our testimony is truer than the testimony of the other two, and we have not transgressed in our statement, for then, indeed, we would become the sinners. Thus, it is more likely that they will either bear the right testimony, or else they will at least fear that their oaths may be rebutted by other oaths. Have fear of Allah, and pay heed. Allah does not direct the disobedient to the right way. The day when Allah will gather together the messengers and say, "What answer were you given?" They will reply, "We have no real knowledge of it. You alone fully know all that lies beyond the reach of perception." Imagine then when Allah will say, "Jesus, son of Mary, recall my favor upon you and your mother, and when I strengthen you with the spirit of holiness so that you talk to people in the cradle, and also when you became of age, When I taught you the book and wisdom, and the Torah and the gospel, and when, by my leave, you fashioned from clay the likeness of a bird, and you breathed into it, and by my leave it became a bird, and you healed, by my leave, the blind, by birth, and the leprous, and when, by my leave, you caused the dead to come to life. And recall when I restrained the Israelites from you, when you came to them with clear proofs, whereupon those of them who disbelieved said, "This is nothing but plain magic." And recall when I revealed to the disciples to believe in me and in my messenger. They said, "We do believe, and we bear witness that indeed we are the ones who submit to Allah." Also recall when the disciples asked, "Jesus, son of Mary, has your Lord the power to send down to us a repast from the heaven?" Thereupon Jesus said, "Fear Allah if you do indeed have faith." They said, "We desire to partake of it, that our hearts be satisfied, and we know that you did speak the truth to us, and that we are its witnesses." Jesus, son of Mary, then prayed, "O Allah, our Lord, send down to us a repast from the heavens that shall be a festival for the first of us and for the last of us, and a sign from you. Provide us with sustenance, for you are the best provider of sustenance." Allah said, "I shall indeed send it down to you. Then I shall afflict whoever among you disbelieves with a chastisement wherewith I will afflict none else in the world." And imagine when thereafter Allah will say, "Jesus, son of Mary, did you say to people, 'Take me and my mother for gods beside Allah'?" And he will answer, "Glory to you! It was not for me to say what I had no right to. Had I said so, you would surely have known it. You know all what is within my mind, whereas I do not know what is within yours. You, indeed you, fully know all that is beyond the reach of perception. I said to them nothing except what you commanded me, that is, serve Allah, my Lord and your Lord. I watched over them as long as I remained among them, and when you did recall me, then you yourself became the watcher over them. Indeed, you are witness over everything. If you chastise them, they are your servants, and if you forgive them, you are the Almighty, the All-Wise." Thereupon Allah will say, "This day truthfulness shall profit the truthful. For them are gardens beneath which rivers flow. There they will abide forever. Allah is well pleased with them, and they well pleased with Allah. That indeed is the mighty triumph. To Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth and all that is in them, and He has full power over everything."